Hello everyone, Dr. Neo here, and welcome back to our channel. Today we will explore the fascinating world, the anatomy of the second most complex organ in the human body, your eyes. First, let's begin by gently touching the front part of your eye. Can you feel that curved, dome-shaped surface? That's the cornea. It's absolutely vital for the cornea to remain clear and transparent, as it lets light rays pass through, helping us see the world clearly. To maintain this clarity, the cornea doesn't have any blood vessels. Instead, it gets oxygen directly from the air, dissolved into the tears, which also nourishes and cleans out the debris. The cornea is also responsible for focusing, by bending the light rays that enter into our eyes. Surgeons use lasers to precisely reshape the cornea during procedures like LASIK to improve focus. And did you know that the cornea is one of the most sensitive parts of the body? It has around 300 to 600 times more pain receptors per square centimeter than the skin, making any corneal injury extremely painful. And this high sensitivity explains why conditions like dry eyes can cause such intense itching and burning sensations. When dust or other irritants touch the cornea, they trigger the blink reflex. This is the fastest reflex in the human body, which makes your eyelids shut automatically and involuntarily to protect your eyes. Interestingly, each blink stands from the outer of the cornea of your eye, sweeping across to the inner cornea, and this motion helps push the tears through the lacrimal sac into your nose, which is why you get a runny nose when you cry. Now, moving deeper into the eye, just behind the cornea, we find the iris, and that's the color part of your eye that makes your eyes blue, brown, green, or any other color. Each person has a unique iris pattern, kind of like a fingerprint, which makes it invaluable for biometric security systems. The iris has a big job. It controls the size of the pupil, and that's the black dot in the middle of your eye. And depending on how bright it is around you, or even how you are feeling, the iris changes the size of the pupil. In bright light, it makes the pupil smaller to let less light. And in dark, or if you're excited, it widens, it opens it, in order to allow more light to enter. Further back, the next stop is the lens, which looks a bit like an almond. It is held by place by thousands of fine ligaments. And while the cornea starts the job by bending the light rays that enter your eye, the lens takes over to fine-tune this focus, adjusting its shape to make sure that the image hits the right spot on the retina at the back of your eye. This ability to change shape for a perfect focus is called accommodation. And here's a cool fact. The lens contains some of the oldest cells in your body. As we grow older, new cells continuously grow at the lens' outer edges, and they slowly push the older ones toward the center. Over time, these old cells, they accumulate in the center, they thicken, and they can make the lens look cloudy. This clouding is what we know as cataract. It's also why, as we age, our lens becomes less flexible, making it harder for the eye to focus on close-up objects, a common condition known as presbyopia. Now, following the journey of the light deeper into the eye, we reach the retina. And this is a light-sensitive layer at the very back of the eye, where the light image is converted into electrical signals. Think of the retina as similar to the film or image sensor in a camera. But instead of a film, the retina uses special photoreceptor cells called rods and cones to capture the image. The retina is packed with about 120 million rod cells, which help us see in low light, making them crucial for night vision. There are also around 6 million cone cells, concentrated mainly in the center of the retina, at a spot called the macula and in the fovea. And these cones are key for seeing colors and fine detail, like when we read. It's quite amazing to note as well that the retina uses more energy than the brain. And speaking of the cone cells, there are three different types: the L cones for red color, the M cones for green, and the S cones for blue. And these cones don't exactly match the colors as we know them, but instead they work together to help us perceive a range of about 10 million different colors in the visual light spectrum that ranges from 380 to 740 nanometers. The true color perception, though, happens when these signals are processed in our brain. Color blindness affects the ability to differentiate these colors and is diagnosed with tests like the Ishihara color test. The complexity of the retina allows it to process visual information at an astonishing rate, which is then sent to the brain via the optic nerve. The rods and cones found in the retina, they are connected with special neurons that gather at a single spot to form the optic nerve. And very interestingly, the spot is also known as our blind spot because it lacks any photoreceptors. It's where the optic nerve leaves the eye to send vital information to the brain. And think about this, our retina and the optic nerve are literally the extensions of our brain. They are a direct biological window into how our brain processes the world around us. How fascinating is that, right? Unfortunately, any damage to the optic nerve in conditions seen like glaucoma can lead to a severe vision loss. And this highlights why regular eye examinations are also crucial, especially if you have a family history of eye diseases. It's all about keeping those windows clear and your vision sharp. And before we wrap up, I have one question for you. If you could enhance one aspect of your vision, whether it's seeing in the dark, perceiving more colors, or having a telescopic sight, what will it be and why? Share your thoughts in the comments below. So thank you for joining me to this journey through the eye. Stay curious, and I will see you in the next video.